بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. In his book Al-Fawaid, Imam Al-Qayyim wrote under the title Kitab Allah Al-Mastur wa Kitab Allah Al-Mandur, the book of Allah that is seen and the book of Allah that is written. قال الرب تبارك وتعالى يدعو عباده في القرآن إلى معرفته بطريقين. Allah سبحانه وتعالى is calling his people in the Quran to worship him in two ways. One way is النظر في مفعولاته, is to look at the creation of Allah, what he created, as one way of to worship him subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second way, التفكر في آياته, is to reflect on his آيات, on his verses that he revealed in the Quran. فهذه آياته المشهودة وتلك آياته المسموعة. One of them, the creation of Allah, are the signs of Allah that you can see. And the other verses, al-ayat, you can hear and you are requested to reflect on. We see this, both of these signs in the Quran. When Allah, example for the first category, the creation of Allah, so many ayat. One of them, إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ وَالْفُلْكِ الَّتِي تَجْرِي فِي الْبَحْرِ بِمَا يَنْفَعُ النَّاسَ وَمَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مِنْ مَاءٍ فَأَحْيَا. To the end of the ayah. Indeed, in the creation of the samawat wal-ard, the skies, the heaven, the alternation of the day and night, the ships that run and sail, the oceans, and Allah keeps going on, the water that comes from the sky, there are signs that the قَوْمٍ يَعْقِلُونَ, for those who reflect. There are signs in there, set in there, the creation of the ocean, the sky, and all of that. We read that again, إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ لَآيَاتِ لِأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ الَّذِينَ يَذْكُرُونَ اللَّهَ قِيَامًا وَقُعُودًا. In the creation of the السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ, the alternation of the day, everything that we see around us, what is in there? آيات, signs. So this is one way we worship Allah, is we look at the creation of Allah, النَّظَرْ فِي مَفْعُولَاتِهِ. And this is so many in the Quran. The other way, التَفَكُّر فِي آيَاتِهِ, reflecting on the آيات of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not only going through them, not only memorizing them and repeating them, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in many آيات in the Quran, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنِ. Don't they reflect on the Quran? Reflection is a higher level of digesting it, getting it through, processing it, thinking of it, trying to get what Allah, the point that Allah is making, the message that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sending. Allah said, as the mission of revealing the Quran, as the goal of revealing the Quran, كِتَابٌ أَنزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ مُبَارَكٌ لِيَتْدَبَّرُوا آيَاتِهِ, a book that we have revealed to you, blessed one. Why do we reflect? Why do we reveal it? لِيَتْدَبَّرُوا, so that they reflect on it. They reflect. We read Quran. All Muslims read Quran. All of them. At certain point, they read Quran somehow. But not all of them reflect on the Quran, or they don't read it like Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and those who really got the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if we look at the one way, the first way of worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, looking at His creation, why do we do that? Or why is it one way of worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? When you look at the creation of Allah, obviously we can't see Allah. Yet we tend to touch things and feel, we need to, where is Allah? How is Allah? How can we? When we look at the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, al-maf'ulat tadull ala al-af'al. If you look at those things, the product should tell you something about how it was created. If you look at a very sophisticated device that you can use it for so many things, you can tell. You can tell that there is so much work behind that. Engineers who put some effort. You haven't seen the engineers. You haven't seen the technology behind it. But you can tell. If somebody tells you this is just a dumb piece of a student maybe in an elementary school put it together, you wouldn't believe them. Even though you haven't seen the engineer, you haven't seen the technology, you know nothing about it, but you can tell from the product, from the action, how much, you know, knowledge was put into it. And that's exactly what we can do when we look at the creation of Allah, not take it for granted. Sun coming every day, moon, rain, skies, don't we really need to look into that? As Allah said, إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ, indeed there are signs for those who look. فَالصِّفَاءِ الْمَفْعُولَاتِ تَدُلَّ عَلَى الْأَفْعَالِ وَالْأَفْعَالِ تَدُلَّ عَلَى الصِّفَاتِ. You know the product, you can tell how much effort is put, and you can tell the qualities of the engineers of the company that put that together. Same way, you can tell how much Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's sifat or features are by looking at his actions, and you can get to know him without seeing him, just by looking at his products and his creation subhanahu wa ta'ala. How can you do that? If you look at how many benefits, interests, that are set in there. Allah said it in such a way that the seeds will go there and then grow up, and then animals will eat from that, humans will eat from that, and seeds will go up again. This same plant will produce seeds, and then the cycle of life goes on and on. You see all of that benefits and how birds are, you know, getting from going through life, how oceans and different species of animals or fish in the ocean are going on. When you see all of that, you see the hikmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or the wisdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you see al-naf' wal-ihsan, how much Allah subhanahu is spending every day, quantities of food, quantities of air that's being consumed, quantities of, you see the rahmah, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you see some signs, you see some floods or thunderstorms, you know that tells you something about Batshul, like the intiqamullah, how, you know, powerful he is, and he can, you know, he is so powerful and he can, you know, get angry subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you see him, you know, throughout the videos that we see subhanAllah, between somebody and death is just a few inches. Somebody was right there and he moved 1 inch, and then a car came right away. And we see that, and we know the rahmah, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or, you know, things are done for some purpose in there. Or the love, maybe he loved that person, or he gives him or her another day to live, and so on. When we see how things start small and grow up, little small tree, and then it grows to be, you know, huge tree. Us, all of us, you see an infant and then growing up, you know that Allah Azza wa Jalla al-Ma'ad can get us, can make, bring us back to life. Because we see it, happening in front of us. وَهُوَ أَهْوَنُ عَلَيْهِ said in Surah Al-Rum, and it's even easier for him. He will start something from there. So when we see something growing up, we know, we believe in al-Ma'ad, or the day of judgment, because Allah will bring us back to life. It's hard for some people to think of that. That all of that, we can, parts of our faith we can get from just looking at the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala around us. That's all telling us about Allah. Now we look at the Quran, or the verses that Allah revealed to us. It's taken us directly to Him. This is who He is. Innani ana Allah, la ilaha illa ana, and what He wants, and what direction in life that He wants, and what pleases Him, and what does not please Him, and what, who are our enemies, and how can we go about our life so clear. Nothing is ambiguous in the Quran. It's so clear. That's who I am, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, and that's who, what He wants from us. He said in the Quran, سَنُرِيهِمْ آيَاتِنَا فِي الْآفَاقِ وَفِي أَنفُسِهِمْ. We will show them our signs in the horizons around them. وَفِي أَنفُسِهِمْ. And so close, it's in their own selves. We show them the signs. حَتَّى يَتَبَيَّنَ لَهُمْ أَنَّهُ الْحَقِّ. So they can, it becomes evident and clear for them that it is the truth. That this religion is truth. Allah is truth. This Quran is truth. أَوَلَمْ يَكْفِ بِرَبِّكَ أَنَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. Was it not sufficient for them to just believe in Him? Everything tells about Him so clearly. Does He have to create signs and tell us and send us? Everything is so clear. But He doesn't just take, tell people that this is the truth and you believe in it, but to show them very clearly in all of these signs in Al-Afaq or Al-Anfus, in the horizons and in our own souls. نسأل الله تبارك وتعالى أن يوصلنا به وأن يعرفنا به. Allah make us get to know Him better and more.